Here is what I think is the absolute worst air conditioner coil I've ever worked on. This is completely bent over, completely. And it's just caked with dust. Look at this. This is insane. I'm not even really sure how to start tackling this. Wow. I've never worked on something this big. Tough. Why bother? Well, I've always had a fascination with taking things that most people wouldn't even touch and then turning them back into something useful. And this machine is, I think it's well worth the time. This is a good quality machine and it should run for many, many years to come. And I have a use for it, so. Going to give it a shot. I'm not going to guarantee that I'll get it going again correctly, because I mean this is close to unsalvageable. And depending on how bad the coil rod is, which I think it's worse than I thought originally, depending on how bad the coil rod is, I'm not sure if I'll be able to get the coil comb through there. This is just incredible. Incredible. The good thing is it's one of the old style coils, so it's straight. It doesn't have that cookie thing in there that newer ones do. So it's a 13 per inch. I don't even know where to begin. Well, let's try to wash off a little bit first with the hose. This is a perfect example of why you don't necessarily need to use a coil cleaner all the time. In fact, a lot of times you don't. Sometimes just a good rinse with decent pressure water. Of course, not too much pressure, but decent pressure water works pretty good. Yep, this is going to be tough. It's going to be a tough one. These coils are in really bad integrity. They're rotten. I mean, the good thing is the coil is so thick, if we lose a bunch of pieces on the front, it's still going to work fine. But this is bad. This is real bad. no, this will not be perfect. It won't really be anywhere close. We're not aiming for perfection. We're aiming for airflow. That's all on this one. We're just aiming for airflow. Most of this, the top layer here is just getting ripped off, but there's nothing else you can do in this case. It's too rotted to correct. This is not really the outcome I was looking for, but again, we get airflow and we can use the machine, so it's better than nothing. What's happened here is the dust has held the moisture up against the coil for extended periods of time, and so it's just rotting it out. At least the front layer is rotted out anyways. Okay, so we're maybe a tenth of the way there. Thank you. This is tough. I'm having a hard time getting through this area. It's just so bent. I can't fathom how it would have gotten like this. This is really odd for an evaporator. Even get somewhere to put the comb in. we're back. This is brutal. Not sure I'll get through this in one sitting. This is borderline like some form of torture. Both for myself and the machine. I just don't understand how it gets like this. This is insane. It was pressed so hard down too. Thank you.
coil comb keeps clogging up. And quite frankly, I don't blame it. This is absolutely ridiculous. Probably not looking much better on the video from that angle, but in reality it really is getting better. It doesn't look great, but that will pass air. That will not. This is bent in too much, I really can't get it. This is not ideal the way I'm doing it now, but still let some air pass. This might be maybe pressure washer damage. I don't know, this is severe. This is the worst I've ever worked on, for sure. And it's been like this for a while because the coil is all rotted out.
which is a result of this. The result of the dust just sticking on there and not getting any airflow and just never drying out. I do it like this because the comb just won't get through there anymore. It's too damaged in this area.
think I'm going to call it there. It's not great. It looks terrible. But I salvaged something that most technicians would have totaled. This one is going back into service. It's not perfect, but it's nowhere near perfect. But at least now we will get air through 75% of the coil, maybe. I think this should be enough that it'll work.